Hello everyone, this is Geeta from the Momentum Lab channel and welcome to this week's video. So this week's video is the series of Factor This, where we understand how different factors have performed in the last 12 months and also how they have performed in the long term, after which we try to understand which are the best performing factors and what are the different mutual funds and ETFs that are available to us in these factors. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So for anyone who's new to the channel, I will take you through the methodology very briefly before going into the exact findings of the factors. But for people who've been following this series and who want to know what are the top factors for the month of December and the mutual funds and ETFs, please skip ahead the methodology and you can directly see what are the top factors, mutual funds and ETFs that are available. So coming to the methodology, we look at two different timelines for how the factors are performing. One is the short term, which we call as, which looks at data for the last 12 months. And the other is the long term. So for a long term, the data period that we're taking is from August 2005. So it's almost like 20 years of data that is available that we choose for long term. And in the short term, we use data both from BSE and NSE. So we have strategies both in BS, strategy indices in both BSE and NSE, and to make and to create sort of an inclusive assessment of all of the factors and how they're performing, we use factor indices from both BSE and NSE. And when we come to the long term, because BSE data is a little bit limited, we have used only NSE data, which is available from 2005 August. While for BSE, the data is much more later than 2005 and it covers really short term. So we have at the moment used only NSE data so that we can keep the robustness of the data. So for the short term, we have 4 indices in BSE and 22 indices in NSE. And what we do essentially is to calculate a month-on-month percentage return. So how we do that is we put N value, the closing value for the last day of the month for each of the last 12 months. And after putting the close value, we calculate a month-on-month return. So this month-on-month return also lets us calculate a factor rank, that is whichever has the highest returns has the first rank, so on and so forth, from the best to worst ranks held. Now, after calculating the factor ranks, we also look at outperformance. So essentially what outperformance is talking about is that it looks at which of these factor indices has outperformed the benchmark. So not only are we understanding how these factors function, we are also comparing them with a particular benchmark. For BSE, the benchmark that we use is the Sensex, and for NSE, the benchmark we are using is Nifty 50. So we look at the outperformance of all of the different factor indices and rank them either 0 or 1. So if a factor has outperformed its benchmark, that is the BSE Sensex for BSE and Nifty 50 for NSE, then it's ranked 1. If it has underperformed the benchmark, it is ranked 0. So this is the table where you can see how different factors have performed over different periods of time. Now, what we also do is to calculate an NAV. We have started calculating this NAV starting from June of 2023. So the idea of calculating an NAV is that we get a sense of equalization or an equal measurement of how all of these different indices move. Now, we also calculate another metric wherein we try and see what is the, you know, what are the factors that have held top ranks, top one or two ranks in the last 12 months. We look at the factor ranks and we also look at which factor has outperformed the benchmark the percentage number of times. So this essentially gives us an idea about which factors are outperforming and which factors are performing better in a period of 12 months. Now, we also try to understand what has been the year-to-date return for all of these factors. So if you would have been following our videos, you'll also have the numbers for the time periods where we have provided all of these factor this videos. And you'll see how, you know, the indices, the returns, return to date for different indices has been changing. In fact, this has been the most drastic change since we have presented the fact of this video. And I will also show you a comparison of these year to date return for the last month and this month. Now, this entire exercise of noting down the closing value, calculating month on month return, looking at the factor rank, Outperformance and NAVs are also conducted for NSE's 22 indices similarly. And then one additional step that we take in NSE is that we ourselves filter out what are the top five or six performing indices. We do this for NSE because there are 22 indices in NSE and it's not very easy to compare what is happening at a glance. So essentially, we would need to simplify it to understand what is the larger picture. Therefore, what we do from our end is to put aside the top five or top six performing factor indices based on the NAVs that we have calculated and we list them down. And for the same top five or six indices, we also calculate the year-to-date return. In fact, these sheets are available, and if you do want to go ahead and calculate some of these year to date from for different periods of time starting from June 2023, you're free to do so. So essentially, that is the methodology where we collect the data on the closing values of all of the indices for last trading day of month, every period that we are looking at, and then we look at month-on-month percentage returns and then rank them from highest to lowest based on the monthly returns. For benchmark comparisons, like I said already, we use BSE Sensex for the BSE indices and Nifty 50 for the NSE indices. And lastly, NAVs are calculated for comparable metrics across all of the indices. And that's how we understand what are the top five performing factors in both BSE plus NSE in the short term. So essentially, because we have a representation from both NSE and BSE, what we do is we have decided to take the top two performing indices from BSE and then add top three performing indices from NSE to make the complete list of top five. Now, if you look at the performance of the factors, we see that December, again, like October, has been somewhat of a bad performing month where we have where all the factors, including the benchmark, has performed in negative. Now, having said that, this BSE Sensex has performed the best, therefore ranking one in the factor rank, followed by low volatility. This therefore indicates that no other factor in index has outperformed the benchmark of BSE Sensex. However, if we look at the percentage number of times if a particular factor has held rank one or two, then we'll see that momentum index has actually held rank one or two most number of times with 54%, and followed by the Sensex 46%, and all the other three factors, which are value, low volatility, and quality, have held it around 30 to 40% number of times. Now, even with respect to outperformance, in fact, all of these figures have been changing throughout the year. So you will be, if you would have been following, you'd understand how different factor rotation has been happening in the market in the last few months, which is a very interesting phenomena for us to observe. And now coming back to the outperformance, we'll see that momentum has outperformed the maximum number of times with 69% instances of outperformance. Again, that is followed by a value, followed by value, 54% percentage times, and followed by quality 46, and low volatility 38%. So up until last month, if you remember, the BSE enhanced value or the value index was the top performing index, followed by the BSE momentum index. In this month, we see a change wherein momentum index has slowly taken over the enhanced value index. Nevertheless, both these indices have remained in the top one and two ranks over the last many, many months since we have been doing this factor this report. So similar is the case with NSE indices. In fact, there has been a good shuffle in the kind of top performing indices that have come up. While alpha, momentum, and value have retained in the first five ranks, the indices which are being represented and the ranks that these three factors held have changed considerably. So this time we have Nifty Alpha 50 performing, having the top NAV, followed by Nifty Mid Cap 150, Momentum 50, followed by Nifty 200 Value 30, followed by Nifty 500 Value 50, And we have the benchmark of Nifty 50. So essentially, while all the factors are outperforming the benchmark that we have considered over here, we can also see that there's a factor rotation in NSE as well. And we also see that there is some factors are starting to outperform the others. Now, I'll just give a brief comparison of how these factors year-to-date returns look like in the last month versus this month. So on the left we have BSE returns. On top is for November, here is for December. If you see that, you know, the enhanced value index had a much higher performance in November year to date return, but that fell drastically for the month of December. However, momentum index still is able to maintain some parts of its outperformance, and across these factors, we even in the BSE we see that their year to date returns have reduced. Now, when we come to NSE as well, we see that the composition of these top performing NSE factors has changed. So the indices are different than they look like in November. And even over here, the Nifty Midcap 150 momentum, that is momentum factor, is showing a higher or a better year-to-date return in December when you compare it with the month of November. So essentially what has happened is that all these factor indices have undergone some kind of correction, and these are how the factors' performances look like in the short term. Now, let me show you the list of the top five factors for this month of December 2024. And like I said, we choose two factors from BSE, the BSE momentum over here and enhanced value. And for NSE, we are representing NSE with three factors. So sometimes in the factor, we can also have two indices being represented, but we are looking at it from the representation of a particular factor. So when we come to NSE factors, we have Nifty Alpha 50, followed by Nifty Midcap 150 Momentum 50. So alpha factor and momentum factor. And the third representation is from the value factor. So we have Nifty 200 Value 30 and Nifty 500 Value 50. So these are the different mutual funds and ETFs that are available for us in both the categories. So one is free to choose. So you are free to choose whichever factor you want to invest in, and the mutual funds and ETFs. So we have also given the data about tracking difference error, where this particular number indicates how closely this mutual fund or ETF is tracking the actual index. So lesser the number, the better it is, because lesser the difference, it's more closer to the actual index performance. Now, wherever there is a gray value which denotes NA, that just means that these funds are new and they have yet to have completed 1 year, and therefore we don't have 1 year tracking difference error. Now, I'd also like to put in a disclaimer that all of this data has come from a website called indiapassivefunds.com, wherein there's a screener and you can put in your particular index and then find the different mutual funds and indices, ETFs that are available. So any new NFOs that have come up, any new funds that have are in their NFO stage, or going to be released soon, have not been included over here. And if you think there is something that we can include, please feel free to comment below, and then we will include it for the next video. So essentially, this website gives us all of this data about which you know, what indices and what ETFs and what index funds are available for a particular index. So these are the top performing factors from both BSE and NSE, and these are the mutual funds and ETFs. So coming to the long term, we have used the data for NSE indices for the last 20 years since 2005. So what we essentially do for this is we collect all of the data points from 1st of August 2025. We calculate the NAVs, we calculate drawdowns, we calculate 3 year returns, and also try to see what the alpha, if there's an alpha that has been generated, and what is the alpha. We also try to look at the volatility, CAGR since inception, and 3 year CAGR and other parameters. Now, after calculating this for all the 22 indices, I have listed them in a table over here. Again, these links are accessible to you when you click on the resources link that is given in the description. Now, after listing all of this data, we also try to give a score. The score comprises of representation in different weightages of all these aspects. So the CAGR since inception is represented, the 3-year rolling CAGR is represented, the alphas are represented with in comparison to Nifty 50, max drawdown, volatility Sharpe ratios, and all of these parameters are included in the score with a particular weightage. Now, this score helps us give a rank, and in the final rank, we choose the top performing, top five performing factors for long-term understanding. Now, we have two indices, Nifty 100 Quality 30 and Nifty 50 Value 20, for which data is only available from 2009. So for these reasons, even though one of it ranks in the top five, we are not considering its actual space in the top five, because a large chunk of good 4 years wherein huge market corrections have happened is not included in this particular index data. So given this, the top performing indices for long term are Nifty 500 Multi-Cap Momentum Quality 50. We have Nifty Mid-Small Cap 400 Momentum Quality 100. Next, we will be skipping the Nifty 50 Value 20 for the reason I've just mentioned. The third rank will be held by Nifty 200 Momentum 30, the fourth by Nifty 500 Momentum 50, and fifth by Nifty Mid-Cap 150 Momentum 50. In fact, the interesting thing that we have to observe over here is that in the short term, in the 12-month period, there has been a lot of change, and there's been a lot of reorganization of which factors have performed well each and every month. In fact, the rotation has been very, very visible when we look at the short term or the 12-month data. But for the long-term data, in fact, nothing has changed since the last month. These five factor indices have been in the top five and in the exact same rank even in the last month. So essentially, except for very minute changes in the tracking errors for both the mutual funds and ETFs, we have not seen a change in the ranks of these top performing indices in the long term. So it essentially says that, it essentially speaks about the stability in the long term, which is where we have to focus our entire investing journey on. And the short term factor understanding is just to see, which factors are performing in what periods of time, how are different factors rotating amongst themselves, etc. So essentially, it gives us an understanding of the market and how factors perform in different time periods and different market frames. But if you're looking at your investment decisions, then it is always best to look at large chunks of data where you have many market cycles, ups and downs, and the data that will throw in front of you is pretty stable. Now, again, some of these indices do not have mutual funds or ETFs, or they have one, or they don't have either. So you can just take a look at this detail, look at this, and then choose the mutual fund that you want, a mutual fund or ETF that you want to invest in. Now, if at all there are more mutual funds and ETFs in one index category, what do you do? Is the easiest thing to do is to look at the tracking difference error. So any mutual fund or ETF which has the lowest tracking difference error or the least tracking difference error is understood to be closely mimicking the actual index. So lesser the tracking error, the better for the better performance of a particular mutual fund or an ETF. So in case you have many options in one factor index, tracking error is a very good parameter to understand and take a decision on which one do you want to invest in. However, what I would like to say is in the long term, because there can be some minute adjustments and tracking errors also. It is important for you to understand the fund and stick by it for the long term to see a certain returns. So in case you're investing today, if you're taking a new investment decision today, then this tracking error comparison will add some value. But if you're already invested in one of the funds and then you see that this month another fund has slightly lesser tracking error, you need not have to shift to that particular fund. So this has been this week's factor this video, and next week we'll come to you with the small case comparisons of all of the factors. We'll see how the small cases have done in the last 1 month. So thank you once again for joining us in this video, and see you in the next video.